Hi everyone, today we will talk about calendar component. Using calendar component you can select a date and you can use that date to refresh your data in your dashboard. Today I will just talk about the component itself and to give an example about the best practice on how to use this. Before I start, let's demonstrate what I will go to teach you today. Now, when I click show, it will display the calendar. I will select a specific date. Notice that the date is changed here. Now it's 19th of December. Then when I click hide, it will hide the date. Let's go and try to do this together. First of all, let's go to components. And let's go to others. We'll find calendar component here. I will drag and drop it here, and I will select one of the text labels. This I will use this text label to display my date just as a runtime. Now I will bind my cell here. I will link to cell. And I will select the date, the default one that I already specified here is 31st December 2012. Okay, now I want to build the hide show button. This is the tricky part. Now I will go to components and I will go to selector and I will navigate to patch button here. Actually, I use two patch buttons, one to change the status to show the calendar and one to hide the calendar. So the first one, it will look here at the Excel model. I make a variable that it should show or hide the calendar. It have two values, one show and one hide. And I will insert the value here in this yellow cell. Now for this patch button, I will rename this as show. And this show button, it will, when you click on this button, it will insert show in the yellow cell. So this means that I want to display the calendar. I will copy and paste. There is another button here. I will name the first one as show also. This is also a good practice to name your buttons and to name your objects in the object browser. This will make you easy to check the components and to select it and to know which component is selected. Now I'm selecting the other button. I will change the label to be hide and it will insert hide here in the yellow cell. Okay, now I have two patch buttons, one to show and one to hide, both of them on top of each other, and on the runtime I want to show and hide the calendar. Now I need to when the show button is displayed, the hide button is hidden, and when the hide button is displayed, the show button should be hidden. To do this, let's go to show button and I will go to dynamic visibility. Here I will mark my status with the yellow cell here. The trick here, when we want to display the show button should be displayed when the calendar is hidden. So I will say that display the show button when the value here is hide, and I will do the opposite with the hide button. I will go here and go to behavior, dynamic visibility. My status is the dynamic cell, which is the yellow cell here, and I want to display the hide button when the calendar is shown because I want to hide the calendar. I will press OK. Now the last step is to configure the dynamic visibility for the calendar. I will select the calendar component. I'll go to the behavior. I go to my dynamic visibility. My status is a yellow cell as well, and I want to display the calendar when the value here is show. So show means that show the calendar. Okay, let's try this preview. Now when I click in show, it will display the calendar. When I select another value, it will here's the calendar. I need also to attach the calendar. There is an insertion type. I will insert date, and I will select that cell, the default one. I will make it as yellow also as well. It is a best practice to highlight your dynamic cells with a yellow background. So let's try it again. Sorry for that. I will click show. It will display the calendar. I will select the date. The date is changed. Another date. The date is changed. When I want to hide it, just I will click hide. It will be hidden. Just before I finish the session today, let's take a quick overview about the feature in the calendar button here. You can insert date or day. And here in the destination cell, it will insert date or day. Here you can insert months, and here you can insert year. So I can insert months here, and I can insert year here. I will make this cell as yellow, and I will display this at the runtime using single value selector here. Let's try it again. I will display the data here in this three cells. One to display the date, month, and year. Let's try it again. I will click show. It display the date, month, and year. Change this. Click November. It will display date, month, and year, and so on. Okay. Now you can see also in the calendar component that you can configure the current date. You can use the current date, or you can use the custom date as a default one. And also you can enable the limits for your calendar. So you can say the start month and start year, end month and end year. So if I make this, my start month is 1st of Jan, Jan 2013. And it will end to December 2013. You will not be able to select any month or any year outside that period. You can check here. I can go to Jan 2014, I can go before Jan 2013 because I configure the limits for this calendar. But for this, for this one, I didn't configure the limit for this one, so I can go to January 2014 and so on. There is no limitation here. I can go also to 2012, 2011. There is no limitation here. Thanks for watching, and that's all for today. Bye.